2018 marked a big year for Tudor when they revealed Black Bay 58 line to commemorate Tudor 7924 Oyster Prince Big Crown from 1958, hence the name of the series Black Bay 58. This commemorative model of Black Bay line was a beginning of a new chapter in Tudor's pages of success, as it was also offered in the original size of 39mm, something that set the 58 line apart from the rest of the competition was the vintage looks that the watch had to offer. It was also offered with aluminum bezel. In the times when ceramic bezel is almost a norm, it had a domed crystal to maintain the original looks from the past. And then especially the gilt dial that made it not just very interesting, but also a unique watch that basically didn't really have any competition in the market. Then while keeping the original Black Bay 58 line in the production, Tudor started to modernize and glorify the looks from 2020 when they released blue dial version with blue bezel and white text, which on one hand took away the vintage vibe of black dial and on the other added more fun and modern looks to the watch. And this year in 2021, Tudor have enhanced the options for the 58 line even further, and we have Black Bay 58 in precious metal now. In this video, we are looking at Tudor Black Bay 58 925, offered in the case made of silver. Tudor call it 925, which basically represents the percentage of pure silver, being 92.5% in this alloy used for this case. If we stick with the generic characters of silver, it is a softer metal than steel. It is brighter, lighter in its shade, and lustrous in its looks. All these characters are what give the silver the jewelry look and experience that it is popular for. And when the purpose of this Black Bay line was to offer a diving watch in the flesh of precious metal, the idea is clear that although it is a sports watch, it is indeed not a tool watch. Rather, it carries with it more characters of jewelry being made of silver than the tool nature if it was made of steel. Tudor do specify that it will not tarnish like typically silver does, but how this case ages is something that only time will tell. From the feel while holding this watch and the case, and especially while gripping and turning the crown, I do feel that it is a softer metal than steel, and it will take the dings, dents and scratches relatively easily. But this is just my feeling. What's even more interesting is that while typically jewelry watches have one aspect common to them, the blingy and the shiny nature, but true to sports watch characters, Tudor have offered the case not just a more understated treatment, rather a different one from what you see in steel versions. The case here comes all brushed, not just on the lugs, but also on the case sides, and this is one difference this silver 58 has from the steel 58, which comes with all polished case sides. There's a beveling at the lugs, and that interestingly also comes with brush treatment to offer consistency and subtlety. The top surfaces of the lugs are also brushed, and overall it works fine and looks beautiful in this combination. There's a screwed on crown with Tudor logo embossed on it. The watch comes with domed crystal on top, which although does add character to the watch, it does also add reflections from the objects around it. And then being domed, it sticks out beyond the bezel surface, making it a little more prone to damaging upon a hit or a drop. Another change in this all new release is the color of the dial, and Tudor have this time released a very unconventional and different color from what we have typically seen in watches, and especially in diving watches. This all new 58 comes in Taupe dial, which does seem to work very well with the brighter looks of silver on the case. The shade of this Taupe color is interesting, where it's neither completely gray nor brown, rather it shares the hues of both, where it is generally grayer in its looks, but with warmer hues from the brown, and even can look to be inclining towards a greener shade under warmer lighting conditions. The texture of the dial is matte, and it doesn't offer any reflections or distractions. The texture on the dial is white, and it matches very well with the brighter shade of the silver on the case. and adds to the overall cooler looks of the watch. The bezel comes in the same shade of Taupe as the dial and is made of aluminum, and I do think it will age aligned with the silver case. The bezel graduations are silver gilded markings which match perfectly with the shade of the case. The bezel comes in the same matte finish as the dial, and overall this also complements the all brushed case on the watch. Speaking of the bezel action, while the bezel sound is very crisp and sharp, there's a backlash or slight play in the bezel action, which was a little disappointing, and this can be seen on any position during the bezel rotation. Speaking of the size of the watch, the size of bezel measured at the outer extremity is 38.9mm, and the size of the case measured diagonally just above the crown is 38.98mm, so it is a true 39mm watch. That being said, the lug-to-lug height of the watch is larger and measures at 47.6mm. For reference, this is slightly taller lug-to-lug than 41mm Rolex Submariner. So although it is a technically 2mm smaller watch, it will not wear any smaller in terms of its height along the width of the wrist. The size of the crystal is 30.6mm, so the face of the watch is proportioned adequately. The watch head only measures at 90 grams on my scale, and I personally do think that it is noticeably heavier than steel references of this watch. The watch although comes with exhibition case back, but if you purchase it in this NATO configuration, the strap will not just hide the case back, you can also not see the movement unless you remove the spring bars. So the way Tudor have offered this NATO combination defeats the purpose of exhibition case back. Removing the strap, however, showcases caliber MT5400, that is COSC certified movement, and operates at 28,800 vibrations per hour to offer 70 hours of power reserve. This is the first Black Bay reference to come with display case back. In fact, this is the first Tudor watch to offer open case back. And while with sapphire crystal on the back, you do get to see the joys of moving parts. The movement finish and aesthetics are just average. It is not as such hot horology movement, so the expectations should be realistic. But even for this price, the movement is just really very average looking, with basic workmanship on offer. I checked the accuracy of the watch over a span of 24 hours, and the watch lost only 2 seconds in 24 hours, which indeed falls within its claimed accuracy, and is an impressive result to achieve. Under the macro, the hour hand comes with polished finish. There's no bevels or chamfers, but then there's also no burrs or high spots, and the edges and corners are nicely finished. Looking at the minute hand, the finish and surface treatment appear to be consistent with the finish on the hour hand, which is nice to see. The seconds hand also comes with no bevels or chamfers, and while the surface treatment looks to be consistent with hour and minute hand, it also looks to be just average. You may see some flaws in this clip, but you can't spot them without the use of loop. The finish on the hour markers is also fine, but what's disappointing is that there's a small particle stuck under one of the hour markers that I can see. Aside from this, the rest of the hour markers look fine. The dial text is crisp and sharp, and overall, the quality here is also fine. As I quoted earlier, that the dial is matte textured. You can also see in this clip the surface treatment and the roughness it comes with to make it look matte and provide a reflection-free texture. True to diving watch functions, the watch comes with a lume that is not just very functional, but is also bright and beautiful. The bezel is not lumed, but there's a lume pip, so it is a fully functional diving watch. I left the watch in the dark for another 5 minutes, and the loss of brightness was not just very consistent, but I could also still easily read the time. On the wrist, the Black Bay 58925 wears relatively larger than a 39mm watch, and this is because of its lug-to-lug of 47.6mm. My wrist size is 6.5 inches and wrist span is 55mm. So although the watch has taller lug-to-lug, it stays in the center of my wrist, and overall, due to its case size of 39mm, I still personally find it on a relatively smaller side for my wrist. and that's because I'm used to wearing 40 and 41 mm Rolex Submariner. The watch case is also relatively thicker than steel models, and here we have 12.4 mm case thickness versus 11.9 mm on the steel models. I personally, however, do not consider this as a thick watch and did not feel it to be thick on the wrist by any means. The top dial provides enough contrast with the skin tone and the case, although the watch face here naturally lacks the rich contrast that the black or blue models offer on the wrist. Tudor Black Bay 58 925 is not just a new release from the brand, rather a very different too. Although Tudor are a sister company to Rolex, they are recently offering some products in the catalog that even Rolex never offered and may also never offer in the future. The 925 is no different, and we have a diving watch in the flesh of silver to offer the luxury experience, looks, aesthetics and feel on the wrist. And then to complement the higher specs, the watch comes with open case back to showcase the heart beating inside the watch. The top dial with the bezel itself is another unique attribute to add to the list. It does, however, comes with its own limitations. The silver case may be softer and show patina with time. The case is slightly thicker than the steel references. And then the NATO strap covers the movement completely, where the case back is open, but you can't really see it. And even when you see it, the movement finish itself is rather just average. Despite everything, if you relate this watch with Tudor's statement line of born to dare, it all falls into place.